So in this tutorial, we're going to have a look at finding estimates for gradients and areas underneath curves. Okay, this is particularly useful when we're dealing with distance time and speed time graphs, but there are other occasions you'll need to use it. So let's take them separately. To find an estimate for the gradient, you will need to draw a tangent to the curve and then find the gradient of that tangent using your normal rise over run. So actually finding the estimate for the gradient of a curve is pretty straightforward. Draw the tangent, find the gradient of that. For the area, it's a little bit more difficult. We split the area into vertical strips, and they will always tell us how many to use. If you have a look at my question here, use 4 strips of equal width, it says. So that's actually not too difficult. We're then going to draw straight lines at the top of the strips instead of the curve. Okay, to replace the curve if you like. Now each strip is a trapezium, or possibly a triangle, and the area of a trapezium is a half of, well, a plus b are the two parallel sides, and h is the perpendicular distance between them, in this case, the strip width. So let's do this now. Here's a graph of, well, as it happens, y equals root x between 0 and 4 on the x-axis, there it is. And we're asked to first of all find an estimate for the gradient of the curve at the point where x equals 1. So, here we go, at the point where x equals 1, well, y happens to equal 1 as well. And I'm going to try and draw a tangent at this point. Okay, so it's going to look a bit like that. That'll do. Okay, there's a tangent. And now, I just need to use rise over run. So let's draw a run there and a rise there. Okay, and mark on there what those two things are. Well, this rise here is 2 minus 0.5, which is 1.5, isn't it? And you can see that the run takes us up to 3 on the horizontal axis. So that distance there is 3. So we can say, having drawn the tangent, okay, let's just make it clear that we know we should have done that, and we did do it. So we've drawn the tangent, and then we can say that the gradient is, well, rise over run, that's 1.5 over 3, which actually very neatly comes out to be an estimate of 0.5 for that gradient. Okay, now we're going to, I'm just going to switch color so I can draw on the graph. Without confusing you with the red bits, and we're going to find an estimate for the area between the curve and the x-axis. So that is this whole area here. Okay, and I'm trying to find that area. Right, okay. So how do we do that? Well, we split that area into 4 strips of equal width. So here's the right-hand edge of the area. So let's then cut it in half. Okay, and cut it in half again, all right, and we get these strips here. So what we've actually got to do is we've got to add up these 4 areas, and I've called them A, B, C, and D. Okay, and so we're going to need the heights of these things. Well, the height of this one is clearly 1. The height of this one looks to be about 1.4. The height of the next one, I'm going to write it on the left of it, is about 1.7, just doing them to one decimal place. And then the height of the last one is, well, it looks, in fact, it is 2, isn't it? Because, of course, it's the square root of 4. And then we join the points, the top of these things, with straight lines. And so we are essentially approximating the curve by a series of straight lines. And we can see, actually, as we get up here, that those straight lines are a pretty good approximation. And we can now say that the area is, well, we just have to add up A, B, C, and D. Okay, A happens to be a triangle, so that's a half the base, which is 1, times the height, which is also 1. B is a trapezium, so that's a half of the parallel sides, which is 1 plus 1.4. Times the width between them, which is 1. C is a half of, Well, the parallel sides are 1.4 and 1.7 times the width between them, which is 1. And the last one, D, is, well, that's 1.7 and 2 times 1 again. And if you stick all of that in your calculator, we find that the area is approximately equal to 5.1. Now, I will just pause to say that, although it hasn't asked me about this, that this is an underestimate. Why is it an underestimate for the area? Because, of course, the lines are below the curve. Had the curve been bent the other way and the lines had been above the curve, of course, we'd have had an overestimate. And that's how you do it.